Thanks much for stopping by to see my project today. I'm going to share with you the box number 2, which is a die, and how I made this pouch that fits inside it for a cute gift idea. Usually box number 2 is made and it has a top, but I cut it out this time and just trimmed off the top pieces and folded it together at the bottom. This die uses 8.5 by 11 paper, and the only tape required is just a little piece of sticky strip to hold your box together at the side. Anyway, I wanted something a little taller to put my gift inside, and so I'm going to show you how I made this pouch. It is a standalone pouch. It is made with box number 2 die, and basically it's the same box. I just extended the top and made it a little thinner out of paper so that it would fit inside this box. And here's how I did it. I'm going to start with 11 by 6 inch cardstock, and I'm going to score it at 1 1/4 and 2.5 inches. So I'll use my Simply Scored. I am going to put the paper in lengthwise, and I'm going to score it at 1 1/4 and 2.5 inches. Then, there it went on the floor. Okay, then you're going to fold your paper at the 2.5 inch score and fold the 1 1/4 inch score back like this. You don't want to burnish these. You just want to kind of fold them and tuck them in together. And the reason you're doing that is so that when you get your die, you're going to be placing those inside the line of the box. And this is the shape of the box. You will want to cut out the bottom of the box, but you will not want to be cutting out the top of the box. So you're going to line up the paper that we just folded inside this cut line, just about like so. And I would cover that with a clear plate on the top and a clear plate on the bottom and run it through my Big Shot. And since I've made this video several times, I can now show you the finished box. It's been assembled, which is just easy to do. I burnished all the fold lines. I did not use a crease pad when I put it through the Big Shot because I did not want to crease these lines that are where we folded the paper. And you might find that on some designer papers, they'll show a little more than others. I really haven't had a problem with that on either of mine too much. And if it bothered you, I think on this one it does show a little bit. You could always just add a strip of embellishment there. But when you assemble the box, you're going to just pleat the sides, make sure they're folded in tight, and then you have a box that will fit inside the box number 2 project, or stand up on its own, like that. As far as finishing the pouch goes, I did use my hole punch and thread ribbon through there, which I pulled tight with a bow on the front. I actually wove it also through the border punch, the lace border punch. You could also fold it down for a topper, or just punch 2 holes and tie ribbon for a topper, or actually cut a topper out of another piece of cardstock and decorate it that way. There are many, many ideas for that, and I'm sure you'll come up with good ones. So I thank you for stopping today to see what I have to share with you, and I hope you will be back. Bye.